I really like this exercise. Is he going to put slabs of meat on your lats? No, absolutely not. Is he going to put a lot of blood in there and make you very like proprioceptively aware of it and, you know, prime you for the rest of your work? Yes, absolutely. So we do that. It's a little bit of pre-exhaustion work, a little bit of pre-exhaustion, never hurt anything. So I'm a big fan. Shout out to Loop for him. What's up, guys? Hunter Labrada here, coming with this week's pro tip. This week I wanted to show you a new back exercise that I've been doing that I picked up from fellow GASP teammate Luke Miller. It's going to be an exercise that I personally would say to start with, and it's going to be a modified straight arm pushdown. Modified in a sense that we are, you know, normally when you see people do these, it's with a rope, or if they're doing a single arm, everything's lined up. The way we're modifying it is we are, you know, cheating over to the point where it's pulling your arm across your body. And the reason that we're doing that is, Jordan, come here. You know, a lot of the time whenever you look at someone, like an anatomic example of someone, you're looking at it like on a piece of paper and it's completely flat, and it completely negates and ignores the fact that you are a human being that's that wide with a rib cage and a lat that wraps around that rib cage. So whenever we come and we offset that arm, whenever we're starting here, you can see your lat inserts right around here depending on who you are and then originates right around here. We're able to wrap that right around the rib cage and really get a full length and stretch. And then as we pull through with the straight arm, get that insertion as close to the origin as possible. So still getting that great contraction, but really getting the arm across the body and fully lengthening the lat at the top. You know, an added bonus, especially for people like me that don't have the healthiest shoulders in the world, anytime that you're able to get your arm like across your body and moving towards the end ranges of motion for your shoulder, under load, that's definitely a positive, and you know, it's going to greatly, you know, increase the stability of the shoulder and the shoulder health in general. I've been doing these for a couple weeks now, and I definitely, you know, in conjunction between these and those supported Y laterals, my shoulders feel much healthier than they have in 3 or 4 years. But I am significantly heavier and stronger than I have ever been. So that normally doesn't correlate. Normally, whenever I'm at new body weights, my shoulders are killing me. So, all right, guys, so to set up on this, what you're gonna wanna do is, you know, hand in here, and you wanna think about the fact that when you're doing this, you wanna get your humerus externally rotated. You don't wanna have the elbow out there. You wanna think about keeping the armpit of your elbow as up to the ceiling as possible, and keeping that elbow as close to the body the entire time as possible. So what we're gonna do is, using a cuff, take a neutral grip. And as you can see, I'm pulley, cable, wrist, elbow, shoulder, all in a straight line. We're gonna cheat over. How much do you wanna cheat over? What I have found to be pretty good for me is outside of the opposite shoulder, equal with the cable. That's enough to really pull the arm across the body without being like super duper excessive, because we're not after that. So lined up like that. And then one of the biggest things that you want to think about is, while it's an isolation exercise here, you need to be thinking about what's happening from the ground up. You need to have your feet spread. You need to have a solid base. You need to be braced. You can't fire a cannon from a canoe. You got to be stable. So knees bent, feet are stable. What's going on up top? You don't want to have a really, really, really bent spine either way. You want to do your best to keep a neutral spine. And then on the side that you're actually doing the exercise to, you want to pay attention to keeping the core tight and the serratus and those intercostals tight. So everything's locked down and braced, and all of the motion is happening at that shoulder joint. The arm path you're going to want to take whenever you initiate this exercise, you want to go down with your elbow. Don't think about pulling back. Think about going down. We want to make this exaggerated arcing path with our hand. The second you start pulling like that, it becomes an upper back trap rear delt exercise, and we're after our lower lats with it. Correlation does not always equal causation, but, you know, I would do these. So anyways, that's this week's pro tip. Hope y'all enjoyed it. Be sure to give it a try and let me know what y'all think. I'll do my best to answer any questions or concerns y'all have in the comments for the first couple days, so let me know what y'all got.